In this lecture, we are going to study a technique called paging, right? This is the most common memory management technique used in modern operating systems. So in the previous lecture, we've seen some simple techniques like base and bound, where the entire memory image of a process was placed as one chunk in main memory, and the base value of that was noted and given to the MMU. In real life, that's not how it happens. All modern operating systems use something called paging, right? So what is paging? You don't allocate all the memory of a process as one chunk. Instead, you split up the memory of a process, the memory image of a process, into fixed size chunks called pages. So the address space of a process is divided into four pages here, for example. In real life, you have much larger pages, much larger number of pages in the address space of a process, and each of these pages is mapped to a physical frame in memory, right? So your physical memory is also divided into chunks of the same size, and you can see that page 0 is mapped to page 3, page 1 is mapped to page 7 in physical memory, and so on, right? So the logical pages, the virtual pages in the virtual address space of a process, are mapped to the physical page frames in physical memory. Okay? So because everything is in these fixed size chunks, you no longer have this problem of fragmentation where a tiny amount of memory is left free between two chunks, or you know, a tiny amount was freed up later but you don't know how to use it, and so on. So you do not have this problem of fragmentation with paging, because the entire memory is just divided into fixed size chunks. Anytime you need something, you can go ahead and use a chunk. But you have a smaller problem called internal fragmentation. That is, if a process even asks you for 5 bytes, you will say, I cannot give you anything smaller than a page. Typical page sizes are 4 KB. So even if the process asks you for 4 bytes, you say, hey, here is 4,000 bytes. I cannot give you anything smaller than this, right? So sometimes some pages may be partially filled because a process cannot use all of it. That is called internal fragmentation, and it is a smaller problem than external fragmentation. So I hope the basic idea of paging is clear. So the key data structure that's used in a paging system is called a page table. So what is a page table? Every process has its own page table. This is a per process data structure that helps in the virtual address to physical address translation. So page table is nothing but a simple data structure, say an array that maps from virtual page number to physical frame number. In the previous example, we had seen, right? We had seen that virtual page, logical page 0, was stored in physical frame 3. So such mappings are stored in the page table. And this is part of the OS kernel code. Say it is usually stored as part of the PCB of a process. Every process has its own page table. When the operating system allocates memory for a process, it remembers, okay, I'm loading the executable. The executable is part of page 0. And I have allocated a page frame number 3 in RAM for this process during creation. Therefore, let me make note of this mapping. Right? So this is stored by the operating system in the PCB. For example, for the simple process here that has page 0, 1, 2, 3 stored here, page 0 is stored in frame 3, page 1 is stored in frame 7, and so on, right? You can see these four different physical frame numbers of this process corresponding to logical pages 0, 1, 2, 3. This forms the page table of this process, and this is stored as part of the operating system code. And the MMU of a process and the MMU hardware, sorry, the MMU hardware has access to this page table. So that any time the CPU accesses some piece of code or data in page 0, the CPU says load something at address number 0. Then the MMU uses this page table. It knows it has to go to physical frame number 3 in order to get that piece of code or data. Right, and note that this page table is a per process data structure, right? So every time you switch from one process to the other, the operating system updates this page table information that is given to the MMU. So the page table is nothing but a series of page table entries, right? The simplest design is a linear page table, which is simply an array of page table entries. Okay, you have multiple page table entries, one for every virtual page. Page 0 has an entry, page 1 has an entry, and so on. Okay, so the virtual page number that forms an index into this page table. So the 10th entry in this page table will give you the information about the 10th virtual page. So what does the page table entry store? Of course, the most important thing it stores is the physical frame number, right? The 10th entry in the page table will tell you where the 10th page is stored in physical memory. Suppose the 10th page is stored in actual physical frame number 100, then the 10th page table entry will store the number 100, saying this 10th page is actually located in this physical frame in memory, right? So that is the bare minimum that a page table entry has to store. In addition to this physical frame number, there's also some other extra information that is stored about every logical page. For example, one is the valid bit. Is this logical page even valid? Note that every process has a large virtual address space. On a 32-bit machine, your virtual address space goes from 0 to 2 to the 32. That is 4 GB, right? A process has 4 GB of addresses available to allocate. But of course, it may not have 4 GB of code and data, right? The code plus stack plus heap, all of this may not add up to 4 GB. Therefore, there are some pages which are simply not valid. They are not even used by the process. So for such pages, the valid bit is not set. A valid bit being set indicates, okay, the process has something stored at this address, either an instruction or some data. Then every page table entry also has some protection bits, right? For example, some pages are only read-only. Some pages are shared between multiple processes and not all processes can edit them, right? So these are slightly more advanced topics. We can ignore them for now. Then there's something also called the present bit. Is this page present in memory or not? Again, we'll come to this a little bit later in the next lecture. Similarly, every page also has some dirty bit. For example, if this page has been modified after it has been loaded into memory. And there's also something called an accessed bit, which indicates if this page has been recently accessed, right? So we'll understand all of these. We'll look at some of these things a little bit later and you'll understand them in more detail later. But for now, note that the page table entry, in addition to the frame number, which it must store, which is the most important thing, it also stores a few other pieces of information about every logical page. And how does address translation happen? So given a virtual address, you can split a virtual address into a page number and an offset, right? So suppose your pages are 10 bytes in size. If you have a virtual address like 112, then you know that 112, the number 11 is your page number and the number 2 is the offset within your 10 byte page, right? So every virtual address, the most significant bits will give you the page number and the last few bits will give you the offset into the page. So the MMU hardware first extracts the virtual page number and the offset, and then it look up the page table to map this virtual page number into the physical frame number. This is done by the page table. So the MMU has access to the page table. How does it have access to the page table? The operating system will tell the MMU every time it schedules a process on the CPU, it will tell the MMU, hey, here is the page table of this process. Note that the MMU only stores the start of the page table. A page table can have many entries, right? It will have one for every page. Therefore, the OS will not give it all those entries. Instead, it will just point it to the start of the page table. And the MMU will use the virtual page number, index into the page table, find the relevant entry, go from the virtual page number to the physical page number, and then add the offset back in order to get your physical address, right? So this is the translation that is done by the MMU on every memory access. Every time the CPU issues a load or store instruction to the memory, this translation happens. So let's now understand what happens on a memory access. The CPU has issued a request to fetch some instruction or some piece of data from a certain virtual address, right? So before this request reaches the memory hardware, the MMU must translate from this virtual address to physical address, right? This request from the CPU first reaches the MMU before it can go to the memory. So the MMU will take this virtual address, read the page table entry, translate from virtual address to physical address, and then it will go and access the memory to fetch the requested code or data. So what's happening here? Paging is adding some extra overhead. The CPU said, get me a certain memory location. Get me something at a certain memory location. So then the MMU said, wait, I don't know where that location is. First, let me go to the memory, read the page table, figure out where that location is, and then once again access memory to fetch the requested code or data. That is, you are increasing the number of memory accesses. You are adding to more overhead on every memory access. Before you can go to memory, you have to first go to the memory to look up the page table, right? So this extra memory access for every CPU instruction becomes too much. Therefore, all modern systems use some kind of a cache for virtual address to physical address mappings, right? So you shouldn't have to go to the page table every time. Instead, the most recent mappings that you've read from the page table, the MMU keeps some sort of a cache where it stores all of those mappings, right? So that cache is what is called the TLB, or the translation look aside buffer. So the name doesn't make much sense, ignore it. But a TLB is simply a cache of recent mappings from virtual page numbers to physical frame numbers, right? All the recent mappings that have been used from the page table. So to translate from a virtual address to the physical address, the MMU will first look up the TLB. And if it finds the entry in the TLB, it will simply go ahead and use that. But if it does not find the entry in the TLB, only then will the MMU access the memory, fetch the page table, and it has to walk the page table. That is, it has to go through the page table, find the entry corresponding to this virtual page number, get it, add the offset, translate. All of that work is done only if this mapping that it is looking for is not found in the TLB. And because the TLB is a cache, it stores the most recent mappings. Most of the time, there's something called locality of reference, right? A program tends to run on the, for example, if there's a loop, you are fetching the same instructions again and again, over and over for every execution of the loop. Therefore, in such cases, if you store a small number of mappings from addresses to virtual addresses to physical addresses, you don't have to go to the page table and walk through the page table on every memory access, right? But if for some reason, whatever you're looking for is not found in the TLB, then TLB misses are very expensive. Right? You have to first go to the memory, fetch the page table, read the page table, do the translation, and only then can you actually go to the desired memory location. And also note that TLB entries are process specific, right? A certain mapping from virtual address number one of one process is not the same as the mapping of virtual address number one of another process. Every process has its own virtual address space. Therefore, the TLB entries also have to be managed during context switches. So overall, this managing this TLB is a big thing. How to ensure that hit rate is high, there's only limited number of entries, how do you evict old entries, all of this is a very complex design problem, but the operating system has nothing to do with this, right? The TLB is completely managed. In most architectures, it is managed by the hardware. The operating system is not involved. The operating system only provides the page table. The MMU, just that the MMU, sometimes it uses the page table, but sometimes it simply uses its own cache in the form of the TLB. So the next question we come to is, how are page tables stored in memory? So what is the size of a typical page table? Suppose you have a 32-bit architecture, you have 32-bit virtual addresses, and you have 4 KB pages. That is, What is the total number of page table entries? You have 2 to the 32 addresses divided by 2 to the 12. That is, you have 2 to the 20 logical pages. Therefore, you have 2 to the 20 page table entries in your page table array. And even if each entry is 4 bytes, you know, to store the frame number and all of those other bits we talked about, then 4 into 2 to the 20. That is, each page table is 4 MB in size. Note that this is not a small number. For every process, you need to set aside 4 MB of memory simply to store its page table. And there are various techniques on how you can reduce the size of the page table. For example, you could use larger pages, right? If you increase your page size by a factor of 2 to the 10 instead of 4 KB pages, if you have 4 MB pages, then you'll have that many fewer page table entries. That is one way. But of course, you can't use really large pages also. It has its other set of problems, right? So given that every process needs so much of memory just to store its page table, how does the operating system allocate memory for such large page tables, right? Your process itself could be very small. The executable itself could be just a few instructions, but still you have to allocate 4 MB for the page table for process. So how do you manage this? The OS once again uses the same technique of paging on the page table itself. That is, the page table itself is split into smaller chunks. It's not stored as one giant thing in memory. Instead, the page table itself is split into smaller chunks, into page size chunks, and each of these chunks is placed separately in the operating system memory. Right? So those are what are called multi-level page tables. So if you had on the left of this page, this is where you see what a single level page table looks like, right? A linear page table. You have a whole bunch of page table entries, and the MMU is given the starting value, the base register, the base address of the page table is given to the MMU. And you have for every page 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you have a whole bunch of page table entries that store a whole bunch of bits and the physical frame number. So if you want the physical frame number of a certain page, you index into this page table, go find the page table entry, and you get the physical frame number and you translate your address. But if you have a multi-level page table, you do something different. This entire page table itself is split into smaller chunks, right? This is one chunk, this is one chunk, and so on. It is split into smaller chunks, and each of those chunks are placed separately into memory. This is one chunk, this is one chunk, and so on. Each of these chunks are placed in separate locations in memory, and there is a outer page table or a page directory which keeps track of all of these page table pages, right? It keeps track of the frame numbers of these page table pages. So if you want a certain, you want to access a certain page table entry, what do you do? You first know the start address of this outer page table. Then you look inside that page table, you figure out where you have to go to find your relevant page table entry. You look up this frame number, you go here, and then inside this you once again index, and then you find your frame number. Right? So depending on how large the page table is, we may need more than two levels. For example, what if this page directory does not fit in one page? Then you might need another level. This page directory itself is split into multiple pages, and you have another outer page table to store all of these frame numbers. Right? So depending on how large your page table is, we may need more than two levels. On 64-bit architectures, for example, you may need seven levels. And how is address translation done? You take the first few bits of the virtual address, you identify an entry in the outer page table. You look up that frame number. Then you go to the next level, the inner page table. Then you use some more bits of, right? One set of bits are used to index into the outer page table. The next set of bits are used to index into the inner page table. And finally, once you've located the page table entry, you translate from the virtual page number to the physical frame number, and you get your physical address. Right? So now in such cases, in case of multi-level page tables, what happens if there's a TLB miss? You have to first, if you don't have the translation in the TLB, then you have to first access the outer page table. You look up a frame number, once again access another memory location, the inner page table, then you look up something else, then the next level, the next level. You access multiple levels of this page table, multiple memory locations until you find the desired frame number that you want, right? So TLB misses can get very expensive. The MMU will only know the address of the outermost page table, the starting address of the outermost page table, and you have to walk the page table over many levels to get to your desired page table entry, right? So multi-level page tables in general increase a large amount of overhead on a TLB miss.